So you've been made the owner of a team. What now? Hey everybody, my name is Kyle, and teams, inside of Microsoft Teams, are the different groups of people getting things done in an organization. Today, let's take a look at how to manage the different settings and permissions that can affect all of the people or channels in a team. To find team settings, click on the ellipses next to the name of a team and choose Manage Team. The first view shows the various members inside of a team, owners, members, and guests. Managing the settings and permissions for a team is the responsibility of a team owner, so you won't see many of these options if you're listed as a member rather than an owner. Here's the view of the team settings screen as an owner and as a member. Members are missing tabs for pending requests and settings. In this member view, owners have the option of promoting members to owners and vice versa. From here, we can add new members as well. The pending requests tab will show you the list of individuals who have asked to join this team. Owners can accept or reject those requests here. The channels tab allows owners to create new channels, see active channels, and push channels as visible or hidden. The ellipses here are the same as clicking the ellipses for a channel in the left pane. The settings tab is where team owners can manage various options and permissions for the entire team. Set a team picture and determine if a team can be discoverable by searching or is invite only. Member and guest permissions include toggles for options like creating or deleting channels, adding or removing apps, and editing or deleting messages. If you want team members to be able to get the attention of all team members, turn on the ability to use at mentions. Below this is the team code. If you want to invite a group to a team directly, this creates an alphanumeric code that will bypass the need to accept join requests. This code can be removed at any time and does not work for guests outside of your organization. Finally, we have fun stuff. Do you want members to be able to send one another GIFs and memes and custom images? The final tabs are for analytics and apps. Analytics gives a glance of engagement in your team, numbers of users, apps, meetings, and more, and activity over time. Use this to determine if a team is worthwhile or if it's just another one too many. The Apps tab will show you every external application added to the team, whether it's a Microsoft service like Forms or SharePoint, or a third-party solution. Apps can be added at any time to teams or channels and can even be built from scratch. A team owner can quickly and easily make tweaks inside of Microsoft Teams to change how work gets done. For more information on how to get the most out of this tool for collaboration, be sure to check out this entire catalog of Teams tutorial videos. We'll talk to you next time. Looking for more info to help you sell even better? Head on over to ExpertZone, Microsoft's online learning platform for courses and classes on all things Microsoft.